Start. So, sir, we'll take it forward. Yes. Good evening. So, first of all, I'd like to introduce myself. This is Dr. Bala Nahak Karthik. You can call me as Bala. That's fine. Okay. Before we start our session, I need to check whether you are aware about chemistry or not. What is chemistry? If physics I will come, you will ask, what is physics? Mathematics I will come. What is mathematics? Fire and flues. What is chemistry? What do you understand about chemistry? Can anyone say? It's a branch of science. Okay, good. Environment? Okay, fine. Then, study of atoms. Okay, fine. Then, anything? Anything? So it's a branch of science, we know. It's a well-known explanation. Okay. Wherever they ask any questions from that, we can say it's a branch of something like that. We can say confidently. We can say, yeah, easy as well. It's a branch of science. So chemistry is nothing but it is a laws of combinations of chemical behavior. Nothing but a laws, L-A-W-S, laws of combinations of chemical behavior. Okay, that is chemistry generally. So the elements are there, the elements that are getting involved in the reaction to attain a stability. So why the chemical reactions will be taking place? The chemical reactions taking place only because of to attain a stability. Okay. Say for example, we have fluorine, F minus and F. Okay, both are there. Which one is stable? Why F is stable? Sorry, it's neutral. Okay, fine. Then any other idea? Why F minus is not stable? What's your name? Surya Kumar. Surya Muthu. Surya. Okay. According to Surya's father, F is stable. But I really appreciate it because he opened his mouth. But nobody is opening. Why? Hesitation. Whether it's right or wrong. No problem with that, just open your mouth. Why is F minus stable? Okay. So with the loss of electron, it becomes stable?
So it's octet
form. Octet form, very nice. Fluorine, what is the atomic number? What's the atomic number of fluorine? 9. 9 is the atomic number. If it is a F minus, how many electrons are there? 10 electrons. 10 electrons. What is the element which has 10 electron? Next to the fluorine? Neon. It's a noble gas configuration. It normally it is used to attain noble gas configuration. That is what it tried to become a stable one. Everybody understand this? Before getting to the topic, just feel some intro. Okay, we have a chemistry, we have a number of categories, right? Organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry, physical chemistry, industrial chemistry, agricultural chemistry, medicinal chemistry, photochemistry, phytochemistry. We have a number of branches, okay. Right? Out of which we have only three classifications will be given to your entire syllabus. What are that? Organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry, and physical chemistry. Okay. What do you mean by organic chemistry? Organic chemistry means? Sorry? Carbon and hydrogen. Carbon and hydrogen. Nice. Then what about physical chemistry? Physical chemistry. Moles. Sorry. Stoichiometry. Okay, nice. Then physical chemistry. Generally, we deal with physical means something is working, is going, some work is going. Okay, physical work. So we deal with the kinetics, thermodynamics. All are coming under this category. Why? Because something is in motion, something is moving. That's what the physical chemistry they say. What about inorganic chemistry? Inorganic chemistry. Sorry, I can't hear. Opposite of organic chemistry. Very nice. Opposite of organic chemistry. Nice. Then, any other thing? Inorganic chemistry, it's a fundamental of all the chemistry branches. It's a fundamental one. We need to study elements. From that element, we start to go with the chemical reactions. Okay? So the chemical reactions only starts with from the elemental analysis we can start. From that element study itself we can start, then we can move on with all the chemistry branches. Okay? That's a base one, that is inorganic chemistry. Okay? Our next thing is organic chemistry in your class 12, according to reduced portions, I do this. So what are all that? Why I am putting first as organic chemistry? Because it has a lot of weightages. Out of 70 marks, we have 28 marks. We can get it, surely we can get out of 28, we can surely get 25. Only 3 marks would be the lagging. Okay. So 25 marks, definitely I assure you, definitely you can be able to get it. 25 marks out of 28. So here we have 5 more chapters. What are all that? The halo alkanes and halo amines. From the word itself, you know that the halo means halogens, halogen family. Why it is named as halogens? First of all, whenever you study, you just ask questions. Why it is named as halogens? Halo, which means that salt. Gen, which means the generator. These group elements which are generating salts. Sodium chloride, potassium chloride, magnesium chloride, sodium bromide, calcium chloride, magnesium sulfate. Okay. Likewise, without chlorine, fluorine, number of salts. Sodium iodide, potassium iodide. We have n number of salts. Am I right? So these are all salt generators. That's what they will be named as. What is that? The halogens. So here, haloalkanes. What do you mean by haloalkanes? From the word itself, we can take an answer. Haloalkanes. The halogen, which will be attached with alkanes. Can you say any example for alkanes? Let's have some example. CH4. What is the name of this one? Methane. Okay. Instead of one hydrogen, if suppose CH3Cl is there, methyl chloride. Nice. CH2Cl2. It's a methylene chloride. The well-known famous compound, CHCl3. What is the name of this? In cinemas, they used chloroform. Chloroform. Any particular? கர்ச்சீஃப் வச்சுட்டு வச்சா கொஞ்ச நேரம் காலி இல்லையா. சோ குளோரோஃபார்ம் which will be used, the wonderful famous compound, very important compound. And next one is CCl4 carbon tetrachloride. So instead of one hydrogen, if I am removing one hydrogen, instead of that I am replacing one halogen. One halogen is replaced instead of one hydrogen, that will be called as methyl chloride. One more hydrogen, methylene chloride. One more hydrogen, we have chloroform. One more hydrogen, we can get carbon tetrachloride. All are halogens. What do you mean by haloarenes? Haloarenes. Haloarenes. Yes. Arene means what? It's nothing but aromatic. Aromatic. Aroma means what? There will be a pleasant smell. Aroma. So from the word aromatic, the compound will come. So aromatic compound, say for example, if I'm taken this as a aromatic compound, I'm having a chlorobenzene. Chlorobenzene. Instead of one hydrogen, what is the molecule formula for benzene? C6H6. C6H12 is a cyclohexane. C6H6 is a benzene. Instead of one hydrogen, I'm replacing with halogen. That's what it is called as haloarenes. Okay. So here also we can replace 6 hydrogen. Instead of that, we can place it 6 halogens. How will you name it? Benzene hexachloride. Benzene hexachloride. Benzene hexachloride is nothing but it is an insecticide. Famous insecticide which will be used in our agricultural field. Okay. And next one is alcohols, phenols, ethers. What do you mean by alcohol? We know that asthma. Yeah. Alcohols on a once the suddenly we in our mind one thing will be strike up, that is asthma. Generally, alcohols are colorless. Alcohols are colorless, but while it is shown in the wine shop, it will be many colors will be existing. Why? Because additives, they're adding some coloring agents. Coloring agents. Sorry? Yeah, that's it. So, ellame ore attraction da vilambaram da. So yeah, ipo epdi vetri nadai podu tamilagam adhu maari da. Sorry? Yeah, definitely. It's not a methylated spray. Okay. And next one is phenols. Alcohols, phenols. What's the difference between these two, alcohols and phenols? Benzene. Okay. If it is attached with aliphatic compound, then it will be called as alcohols. If it is attached with, that is, OH functional group is attached with benzene ring directly, then it will be called as phenol. You know the functional group everything. Then ethers. What do you mean by ethers? Ethers, ROR. That's a functional group of ether. Okay. Most probably they are all inert compounds. They are all inert. Generally, it will be used for used as a non-polar solvent. Solvent purpose only. We are using this. Okay. And next one is aldehydes. What do you mean by aldehydes? Where it is used? Nowadays we are using perfumes. Perfumes which contains many aldehyde compounds. Perfume contain many aldehyde compounds. Okay. Benzaldehyde. Where it is available? Heard about that? But daily we sell a bit of it. Almonds. So take an almond, right? Almond consists of rich of benzaldehyde. Okay. Then ketones. What do you mean by ketones? Where it is used in day-to-day life? Sorry? Nail polish remover. Very nice. Nail polish remover we are using. Even for rubbing of this black color markers, we can use Otherwise, we can use a diluter. We use as a diluter for putting paint. Okay, usually the paint will be a very solid one. Yes, a semi-solid one. If you want to make it a liquid-like structure, we can add some solvent to that. So the ketones will be as generally as a solvent. Solvent atom. Okay. And next one is a carboxylic acid. Naturally obtaining substance. Carboxylic acid. Formic acid. It's a kind of acid. One carbon containing acid. HCOOH. It's a formic acid. Where the word comes from, the formic acid? Formica. It's a Latin word. Formica. Red ant. Red ant. It's a name. And the oil is there. That's initial find it. Then there's another formic acid. Acetic acid, these are the common names of substance. Acetic acid, where does it come from? Acetum, acetum the word. Acetum is nothing but vinegar. Nowadays we are using fruit vinegar like that. We are using day-to-day life, the chemistry is a interrelated one. We should not avoid chemistry anywhere else. Anywhere avoid one of the other. Correct? Even oxygen you are respirating. Oxygen is a kind of element, correct? Then amines. What do you mean by amines? You heard about any word like amines? In your daily life, you can drink amines. But ammonia, it's a kind of ammonia derivative is amines. Then, did you heard about vitamins? Vitamins. They are all nothing but a vital amines. It's called the vitamins. Vital amines. These are all much needed for our body. Something can be synthesized from our body. Something cannot be synthesized from our body. They can be categorized further into essential, non-essential. If it is essential, we must take out from our external sources. If it is non-essential, yes, our body can synthesize the amines. Body itself. Then biomolecules, very, very important one. Biomolecules, carbohydrates, vitamins, amino acids. Even without biomolecules, we can't live. Without biomolecules, we can't live. DNA is a biomolecule. RNA is a biomolecule. Okay, it's a constructing material of everything. Proteins, biomolecule. Carbohydrate, biomolecule. Glucose, fructose, maltose, sucrose, everything is biomolecule. Okay. These are all the things we are going to discuss in organic chemistry. What about physical chemistry, in which we are going to study about the solid state? What do you mean by solid state? Solid means solid matter. Solid. It has definite shape. Yes. Shape. Right. Definite mass. Definite volume. Yeah. Solids. Now here are two more categories. Crystalline solids, amorphous solids. You know that. What do you mean by crystalline solids? Structure. It's nothing but structure or the arrangement of atoms. Will be uniform throughout the entire compound. That is coming under solid state. We are going to discuss crystalline, amorphous. No. Our next one is solutions. What do you mean by solution? It's a very important and interesting one. Solution. What do you mean by solution? Solution. Dairima solving. தப்போ ரைட்டோ பிரச்சனையே கிடையாது. சொல்யூட் பிளஸ் சால்வெண்ட். வாட் டு யூ மீன் பை சொல்யூட்? வாட் இஸ் சால்வெண்ட்? அங்கே சொல்லிட்டு கொஞ்சம் சத்த பசங்க. யூ நோ தட், உங்களுக்கு தெரியுது. தென் வை யூ ஹெசிடேட்? சொல்லுங்க, ஓபன் பண்ணுங்க. நோ ப்ராப்ளம். ஓகே, சொல்யூட் விச் இஸ் கோயிங் டு டிசால்வ் இன் சம்திங், ரைட்? How can we identify solid as solid? Solid is a solid. Dissolved. How to find out? So lower the quantity they are taken from the both, that will be act as a solute. Higher the constituent or higher the amount what we are taken, that is acting as a solid. Say for example, I am having a liquid water. Liquid water. Just I am dissolving 1 gram of salt. Now it becomes a solution. Salt solution. The lower the quantity, the salt will be taken as a solute. Higher the amount, the water will be taken as a solid. Okay.
Which we have many more categories. Based on that solvent,
then based on that solvent, if the solvent is water, then it will be called as aqueous solution. If it is solvent is except the water, it will be called as non-aqueous solution.
We have many more categories to discuss. Then electrochemistry.
What do you mean by aqueous?
Is it possible to solve? That's true.
Universal solvent means like dissolves like. That is very important. If it is a universal solvent, what is the universal solvent? Absolutely, it's right. Whether we can dissolve ions? Fine. Because the like dissolves like, the polar solvents can be used to dissolve the polar substance, like polar solutes. Non-polar can be dissolved in non-polar solutes. That's the kind of difference. Then electrochemistry, where we are using electrochemistry, everything is electrochemistry. Nowadays we are using this, it's also electrochemical application. We have batteries. We have batteries. Also electrochemical applications. They are using fans. They're using the tube lights. Everything is working under electrochemical principles. There are two more classifications: electrochemical reaction, electrolytic reactions. If the chemical reactions can produce electricity, then it will be called as electrochemical cell or electrochemical reactions. From that, or if you want to conduct any chemical reaction by the application of electricity, that will be called as electrolytics. So, Brida, chemical energy can be converted into electrical energy. If electrical energy can be converted into chemical energy means, or electrical energy which is used to conduct a chemical reaction, that is electrolytics. Yes, which means that the chemical reaction will be conducted only in presence of electricity. Because electricity, some reactions don't happen. Because some reactions will not happen on its own. Say for example, spontaneous, not spontaneous, you know that very well. What do you mean by spontaneous? Spontaneous which not mean that sudden. It's not an instant process. It's automatic process. It's an automatic process. Say for example, we have a waterfalls. From the top to bottom, it will fall. From bottom to top, we need to give energy. To pump it out, we need to give some amount of energy. That's a opposite reaction. Okay, that's a non-spontaneous reaction. We need to apply electricity, then only it will become a reaction will be possible to the forward direction. Okay. Electrochemistry, then kinetics. Everything is moving towards kinetics. Kinetic means what? Kinesis, the word. Kinesis, the movement of chemical reactions. Chemical kinetic means the movement of chemical reactions. So the movement of chemical reaction may be forward or maybe backward. Based on that condition, we are going to discuss all those things. Okay? Chemical kinetic. Then surface chemistry. What do you mean by surface chemistry? The new term, surface chemistry. Application day to day life, we have many more applications in surface chemical principles. Gulab jamun குலாப் ஜாமுன் சாப்பிட்டுருக்கீங்களா? எப்படி இருக்கும்? டேஸ்டா இருக்கும் இல்லையா? அது செய்யற ஆளை பொறுத்து இருக்கு இல்லையா? அப்ப குலாப் ஜாமுன் எண்ணெயில போட்டு பொறிச்சிட்டீங்க, எடுத்துட்டு சீராளம் உள்ள போட்டுருக்கியா, சீராளம் உள்ள போட்டுட்டு உடனே எடுத்துருக்கு, உடனே சாப்பிடுறீங்க. Is it tasty? Why? Sweet. Okay. Yeah, that's it. That's what I'm expecting. Initially, if you take a gulab jamun, that gulab jamun put into the seera, and just it stick on to the surface only, initially. If time goes on, it will get absorbed in the bulk also. Getting absorbed in the bulk pulse. The jeera molecules will penetrate into the gulab jamun. Then only it become a tasty one. So initially the absorption will be taking place on surface only. After that the absorption will be taking place after some time. Simultaneously both processes are going. So in the mariana chemical reactions, say for example we are using catalyst. Ranelagh used a catalyst. You heard about that name, ranelagh, palladium hydrogen, platinum hydrogen. It should be used as a catalyst. Why? On the surface of catalyst, the hydrogen gas is going to absorb out. Is that clear? Purida? Metal nudiya surface la hydrogen gas is getting absorbed. It's a kind of absorption process. So that kind of reactions, even we use the catalyst. What do you mean by catalyst? Catalyst means catalyst. It boosts up the speed of the forward reaction. Okay, fine. Then any other definition for that? Catalyst is a substance which is used to alter the rate of reaction, whether it may increase or it may decrease. But generally for the reaction purpose, we can't use it for the decreasing purpose. We need to increase the rate of reaction. Instead of increasing the temperature, we can use a catalyst. Temperature increase panni reaction slow pandradhukku badhila, we can use a catalyst as an alternative. We can use it. So the catalyst will increase the rate of reaction or decrease the rate of reaction. Catalyst does not initiate the reaction. Let's not initiate the reaction. Already some reaction is going. Just you are adding catalyst to that, it may increase or decrease the rate of reaction. The same time, the catalyst will not involve in the reaction. Reaction involve other things. Let's not take part in the reaction. After the completion of the reaction, the catalyst is getting regenerated. At the synodon. Complete theory, theoretical aspects. You already studied about what is that S block, P block, la padichirukke illaya. So adula P block, what do you mean by P block elements? P block elements have some special characteristic. Of course, the entire periodic table, we have some special characteristic of a P block elements. Some of the properties are entirely different for P block elements. Inert pair effect. We studied about inert pair effect, am I right? Have you heard about that word? Okay, fine, nice. Inert pair effect is only for P block elements, not for all the elements. Only for P block elements, we have inert pair effect. And one more thing, the entire periodic table, three more classifications will be coming under a single block, that is P block, which may contain metals, non-metals, even metalloids. If you take on a D block, everything is a metal. No problem with that. If you take on a what is that? S block. So the alkali metal, alkaline death metal, we have classifications. D block completely metal. F block, lanthanoids and actinoids. It's very going to say. What about the D block? It consists of metals, non-metals, metalloids. So the variation of physical properties enormous. Every property variation. Yeah. Then D and F block. Very simple. Everything is metal, so properties are almost same. Okay. We can discuss later. Then coordination properties. What do you mean by coordination properties? The word indicates coordination. So what do you mean by covalent bond? Covalent bond and electron. Sharing of electron. That is a mutual sharing of electron. Your electron today, our electron tara, both we can combine to form a bond. Mutual sharing of electron. What do you mean by coordination bond?
Only one thing, sir. Yeah, when the electron is non-neutral, the MP electron, that kind of bond is called coordinate bond. Mutual sharing of electron, so A, B, A will give one electron, B will give one electron, that is covalent bond. Coordinate bond means A doesn't have electron, but B can donate electrons, two electrons to form a bond.
That kind of category is called coordinate bond. Okay. And these are all the questions. Then question paper format. How the question paper will be asked? Totally 33 questions. 33 questions will be given your question papers. Generally, there is no choice. There is no choice in question paper. Sometime they may give internal choices. Sometime. Some of the questions will have some internal choices. Okay. You can write either this or this. That may be given in 3 marks or 5 marks. Most probably. We can't assure that. So they can give any time. They will be changing. And they can be setting the question paper to classifications. As far as, what is that? Section A and Section B. Section A, which consists of multiple choice questions. Multiple choice questions. அது எங்க இருந்து வரலாம்? Either it may be objective questions are long, or otherwise what is that? ஒரு paragraph கொடுத்து அதுல இருந்து questions கேக்கலாம். Anything they can ask. Association will also be there. Definitely will be there. So once you understand the concept, you can be able to easily answer the assertion and reason. Okay. Assertion reasoning பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் எல்லா பசங்களும் பயப்படுறது என்ன அப்படின்னா, they are not confident on concept. That's what. Okay, once you study in depth, you can be able to answer any questions. But ஒண்ணே ஒண்ணுதான், but your interest is must. 100% cooperation இருந்தது அப்படின்னா, definitely we can do it. No issues. But we need 100% cooperation. That is must. Okay. Then question 1-2. Passage based question, that is a paragraph kuduthu adula and questions kekpaanga, so 4 marks irukum, rendu question 4 marks kudu. Then question 3 to 16 they will be giving carrying 1 mark each, the objective irukalam or innovana irukalam. Okay, so assertion reasoning irukalam, indha maari irukalam. Okay, then section B from 17 to 25 short answer question, which carries 2 marks each. Question, there are 2 mark questions and the range where. Then 3 mark question we have 26 to 30, the range where put on it. 3 mark question, big question pathina 31 to 33, last three questions, big questions are. Yeah, parunga there will not be an overall choice adum kadaiyadhu, sometimes internal choices. Yeah, then objective type token we have what is that? 1 mark question, 19 questions, totally 19 marks. Percentage paathina 54% paathiyala totala 35 marks adula 19 marks enga vanduchu objective type kekutten. Okay, remaining 2 mark question, 5 questions, so totally 10 marks, 28% weightage paarenga inga kudukuraanga paarenga. Then case based question, 3 mark question also they will be asked.
in which we have two questions that can carry 3 marks, total 6 marks, total 35 marks for section A. Section B, short answer, that is 2 marks. 4 question, 8 mark. Then short answer, 3 question, 3 mark question, 4 questions, carries 12 marks. Long answer, 5 questions. 5 more questions, 3 questions, 15 marks.
Then domains.
What are all the domains they're asking questions? Very important. You know, idhalo therinjada nam eppadi prepare aagum. Yeah, that's what I think in this slide. So the remembering and understanding abilities lernde 40% questions are coming. So the memorizing capacity should be very important. Some of the, no need to memorize everything. Memorize la edhu panna vendiya avasiyam illa, neriya panna vendiya illa, but we need to memorize something. Nyabagam vechukonga seradha. Yeah, adu mattum paathu 40% irukum. Then whatever the concept you know, you should have the capacity to apply in a conceptual. Conceptual apply panna theriyum. So from that question they can ask 30% of the questions will come from that area. And next one is analyze. Whatever the questions, whatever you know that knowledge, you have some conceptual understanding, you're applying everything, but analyzing type of questions will be coming. So nearly 30% contributes. And practicals. Practicals is a polymetric analysis, then salt analysis, functional group determination, something, some school to school may vary. Then content based experiment. Totally 30 marks which carries. Okay. And then you studied about a class 11 and class 12. So why I'm putting some more colored? Can you able to see the colors? Okay, fine. The first unit in 11th, some basic concepts of chemistry. You studied about some basic concepts of chemistry. Where we can use, what all the things are there in basic concepts of chemistry?
Moles,
stoichiometry, then molarity, molality, mole fraction, molecular mass, then equivalent mass. You can have everything that can be. That these were the basic concepts. 11th is completely basic, completely entire is basic concept. By using this basic concept, you can able to apply for concepts. Just 11th enna padichinga adha be extended version avada extended version of 11th da 12th but 11th avada 12th is very easy because you know the fundamental concept once you can easily apply it. That is very easy. Okay. So almost inga pathina solid state la we can use it and solutions first unit theriva therinjina some basic concepts of chemistry if it is clear on that we can easily solve the questions coming from solid state solutions. And next one is structure of atoms. Structure of atoms, you know that. So in 12th standard we can use it in D block, F block, B block. We can use it everywhere else.
Photoelectric effect.
It is very less contribution there. Then classification of elements in periodicity in properties. The periodic classification. What are the periodic classifications? Enna kudukalam neriya kudukalam illa. What are the periodic classifications? Sorry.
Inert gases.
Para. Okay. Metals. Then non-metal. Metalloids. Para. So P block, D block, then all category level level. Yeah, you know that electronegativity. What do you mean by electronegativity? Tendency of an element to attract a shared pair of electrons. What do you mean by shared pair of electrons?
Which is already in bond.
Say for example, if we take an HF, HF is a molecule. Okay, you know what is electronegativity? Then we'll conclude this. What is electronegativity? So it's a
pulling tendency of electron, pulling tendency of an atom. So what is the which element has higher electronegativity in the entire periodic table? Fluorine, 3.8 something. It's the most high electronegativity in the entire periodic table. Okay. But then we can try to pull the shared pair of electrons. What do you mean by shared pair of electron? Here hydrogen will give an electron, fluorine will give an electron. So the entire electron, the two electrons can be pulled by, pulled towards to fluorine because it has high electronegativity. Then only it will be existing as a charges. It's like negative charge carried by fluorine. Loss of electron, it carries positive charge on hydrogen. Okay. That's what the loss of electron will give its oxidated state. So it carries positive charge. Gain of electron, nothing but reduction process. Loss of electron, oxidation, gain of electron, reduction. You know that very, very important. Then that is electronegativity. And then what I asked earlier, electronegativity, periodic classification then. Okay, fine. Okay, we have electronegativity, electron gain enthalpy. We have number of classifications, number of properties are there. Okay. Many number of properties are there. Periodic classifications, periodic properties, or periodic trends. And next one is a chemical bonding and molecular structure. The most important, unit. Right, chemical bonding and molecular structure. Here you discussed about the hybridization, molecular orbital theory, MOT. Then what about that valence bond theory, DPP, VSEPR, valence and electron pair repulsion theory, everything you study, right? So based on that, if you know the concept very well, you can be able to solve the questions from the coordination compounds very easily. Okay, the coordination compounds we can solve it very easily. We have even a D block also, we have some compounds. P block also, we have some compounds like the xenon compounds. Even you have a textbook, plus two textbook irukka clear vechirukinga atta page romba mukkiyam front sheet irukla front page irukla book nudeya front page irukla that is very much important. Why? Because every year they are asking one question from the front page or back side of the book. Kodutirupanga one mostly formation kodutirupanga chemistry book eduthu paருங்க volume 1 2 everything you can see. Xenon compounds is a very very important compound. All the hybridization structure everything we are going to discuss. Yeah, ellame indra undu. Then state of matter, gas and liquid, general application, everything will be very important. Then chemical thermodynamics. If you know the chemical thermodynamics, we can easily solve the surface chemistry principles. Then equilibrium, which is very important. So its extended version is chemical kinetics. So equilibrium chapter ona theriva therinjadhu appadina we can move with that chemical kinetics chapter. That is very easy. And next one is a redox reactions. Normally it should be used in electrochemistry. We have redox reactions. And then we have a D block. We have a number of redox reactions where we can use K-menophore, potassium dichromate. These are all good oxidizing agents which are going to involve in redox reaction. Okay, do you know what is a redox reaction? What is a disproportionation reaction? Redox and disproportionation. What's the meaning of that? Simultaneous, very nice. What about the disproportionation? Same compound, very nice. Suppose if I'm taking A, A will be acting as oxidizing agent that is going to oxidize the compound B. Once the B is getting oxidized, A will get reduced. Okay. Suppose you are taking only compound A. A will involve in oxidation as well as reduction. That kind of reaction is called disproportionation works. Okay. The next one is a hydrogen. Hydrogen, that is very, very important chapter. Because in electrochemistry, we are going to use the hydrogen. Standard hydrogen electrode, you can say C. Standard hydrogen electrode. Entire electrochemistry will depend on electrochemical series. If you know the electrochemical series and its concept, clearly you can be able to answer any questions asked in the area. Very simple. And then the S block elements. One, na, enga irukum? 11th irukum, 12th irukum, koncham sambandham illada maari irukum. Yeah. Remaining all chapters are interrelated. The next is P block elements. Our extended version na, enga irukudi P block elements. You studied about 13, 14 groups. Here you are going to learn about 15, 16, 17, 18, everything. Okay. The next one is organic chemistry, basic principles and techniques. Most important unit for organic chemistry. Most important unit for organic chemistry. Here, what do you mean by nucleophile? Do you know anything about nucleophile? Sorry? Electron?
See.
Electron receiving?
See.
Electron seeking? Ah, very nice. Okay, then. It gives electron to the reaction. Whether it is electron rich or electron deficient. Nucleophile. Deficient. So what do you mean by nucleus? What is the charge of nucleus? Charge of nucleus. Positive. Nucleophiles. Files. The word means loving or attraction. Nucleus, that's positive charge. If the nucleophile, which is going to attract by nucleus, then what will be the charge of nucleophile? Nucleus would be a charge positive. If it want to attract it, what will be the charge of nucleophile? It should be negative. So electron rich. What do you mean by electrophile? Electron loving. Electron has negative charge. It loves. What is that? Negative species means it has positive charge. Electrophiles. Nucleophiles, electrophiles. It's not very much important. What do you mean by free radicals? Free radicals. You all know about. You should know this, all those things. Electrons.
Sorry.
Okay. Any other thing? Any other definition? New, what is the radicals? Free radicals. From the word itself, free radicals. It is free. It's always free to involve in the reaction. It is always undergoes homolytic cleavage. What do you mean by homolytic cleavage? Homolytic cleavage means two equal parts are getting divided. Equal part are divided out. Yeah. That is called the homolytic cleavage. So equal part means each get one electron. So the free radicals which will be represented as R dot. The dot will be there. R dot. If I'm having chlorine, Cl bond. If I am passing light on that, what will happen? The chlorine will take one electron. This chlorine will take one electron. I'll get 2Cl dot. That's a free radical. Another free radical is near to it. Saturn will form a bond. Saturn is most reactive. It carries a single electron species, which will be more reactive. Easier reactor. That kind of species are called the free radicals. Nucleophiles, electrophiles, free radicals. My important classifications. But I'm a dungeon. So you know that. Idhula ellam therinjadha enna panna mudiyum? We can able to solve. We can able to attempt the question from organic chemistry. Organic chemistry, the question touch panna, you should be very strong in some basic principles and techniques. Basic principles you can study, that is important. No need to study about the techniques. That is different category. We no need to have. The very important thing, basic principles involved in the chemical reactions. How the chemical reactions will be taking place, how the electrons are getting shifted. So if it is aromatic compound, why the resonance will be taking place? What do you mean by resonance? What do you mean by inductive effect? Everything you should know. These are all very important things. And then hydrocarbons. If you know the hydrocarbons, we can able to learn about easily about the haloalkanes, halorenes, and alcohols, phenols, ethers. And then amines. So amines, we have number of categories: primary, secondary, tertiary, mixed amine. Then what is that? Simple amine. Have number of classifications. We'll discuss from there. Then biomolecules. As I said, it's very very important compound. Without biomolecules, we can't live. Okay. These are all the very very important things. Okay. Our next one is, suppose. Have you heard about intermolecular forces? Intermolecular forces. What do you mean by intermolecular forces? You can say I. Sorry. How? Intermolecular forces, IMF. What are all the intermolecular forces? Hey, whether it is right or wrong, don't hesitate. உனக்கு தெரிஞ்ச சொல்லிடு, தப்போ ரைட்டோ பிரச்சனை கிடையாது. தப்பா சொன்னா கத்துக்க போறோம், ரைட்டா சொன்னா அப்ரிசியேட் பண்ண போறேன், அவ்வளவுதான். நத்திங் எனிதிங் யூ நோ அபவுட் இன்டர்மாலிகுலர் போர்சஸ்? You heard about the van der Waals forces, weak van der Waals forces. It always said as weak. Why it is weak? Why it is a weak force of attraction? Because normally it will be taking place in non-polar molecules. Non-polar molecules, which is not going to separate as charges, plus negative charges, nothing is existing. No charge will be produced. That kind of molecules will have and the walls forces of attraction. Ab eppadi irukum, say for example, if I'm taking a nitrogen, what is the atomic number of nitrogen? Atomic number 7. What about the valence electron? 5 valence electron. Nitrogen here only form 2 bonds, sorry, 3 bonds. What about the remaining 2 electrons? The remaining 2 electron will be existing as lone pair, which will not be returning any book. Why? Because that is default. That is default. Okay. In older books, we have the nitrogen with the lone pair, they return. But nowadays, new books, they are, it will be considered as default. And how it involves in van der Waals force of attraction? Nothing but very simple. It has 2 electrons, lone pair of electrons. Here also we have 2 lone pair of electrons. The 2 electron, 2 plus 2 electron, all the 2 electrons will go here. Because electrons are always moving around the molecules. Electrons are always moving around the molecule wherever it can exist. But it is very, very short period of time. Even below the nanosecond. Very, very short span of time only. This shifting of electrons and returning to the original state is will be happening. Is it clear? Purida? So it's a non-polar molecule, I say. It has 2 electron, it has 2 electron, no problem with that. However, it will appear with them, it's negative. There is no chemical reaction. Okay. But it wants to involve chemical reaction. Because it needs to attain. That is what it's moving towards, 2 electrons. The electrons are moving for some span of time. Some span of time it's moving. Once it moves, this will lose its electron, this nitrogen 1, this nitrogen 2, you can see. Nitrogen 1 will lose its electrons. So it attains light positive charge for some time. Nitrogen 2 will get 2 electrons, got negative charge for some period of time. Now the molecule become polar. Non-polar molecule, which is becoming a polar molecule. Now it will induce the nearby molecule. Nearby we have one more nitrogen molecule. Here we have more number of charges. That charges will repel these two electrons. Repel these two electrons. Then it will get slight positive charge, it will get slight negative charge. Now we know that here it has slight positive charge. Here it has slight positive charge. Here I have a slight negative charge. Now the forces of attraction between the two molecules will come. This is called van der Waals forces of attraction. At any point of time, the electrons may return to the original state. That is what it is, a weak force of attraction. Is that clear? It's a very, very weak force of attraction. Why? Because at any point of time, the bent electron may go back to their original position. It's a weak van der Waals force of attraction. This is called van der Waals force of attraction. And next force of attraction is DPDP. What do you mean by DPDP? Dipole-dipole interaction. What do you mean by dipoles? From the word itself is there. Dipoles. Two poles. One carries positive charge, one carries negative charge. They have permanent dipole moments. They have permanent dipole moments. Okay, say for example, I'm taking a HCl molecule. Here also an HCl molecule. We know that chlorine, bromine, iodine, these are all electronegative when compared to hydrogen. What is the electronegativity of hydrogen? It is 2.1. What is the electronegativity of chlorine? Almost three, 2.98, something like that. Okay. So the electronegativity difference is there, so it can pull the shared pair of electron towards two chlorine. So it got slight negative charge, slight positive charge, which will induce the nearby molecule to the same category, slight positive, slight negative. But you get the force of attraction will be there between the two molecules, this chlorine and hydrogen. We have force of attraction. So between the two molecules, the height, that means the interaction will be there. That is what is called as dipole-dipole interaction. Molecule 1 has dipole, molecule 2 has dipole. Both dipole are getting interacted with each other, then it forms dipole-dipole interaction. And next category, what is the next category? Hydrogen bonding. What do you mean by hydrogen bonding? Interesting one. Hydrogen bonding. I didn't know. Hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding. Bonding of hydrogen atom with molecule. Very good. Better. For example, if I'm taking CH3, here also CH3, ethane, whether it forms hydrogen bonding?
Sir?
Yes. How many of you say yes?
Sir, only one. Those two molecules, it won't work, sir.
Okay.
Molecules separately, hydrogen
bonding. Hydrogen bonding is there. Okay, fine. Okay. Very nice. That is what very important. So only three atoms which forms a hydrogen bonding. எப்படி ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கலாம்னா, சுவிட்ச் ஆன் ஆஃப், அவ்வளவுதான். ஆன் ஆஃப்.
ஆக்சிஜன், நைட்ரஜன், குளோரின்.
ஒன்லி த்ரீ மாலிகூல்ஸ் வில் ப்ரொவைட் அ ஹைட்ரஜன் பாண்டிங். வேற எந்த ஆட்டமும் என்ன பண்ணாது, ஹைட்ரஜன் பாண்டிங் ஃபார்ம் பண்ணாது. ஈவன் நவ் இட் இஸ் ஹைலி எலக்ட்ரோநெகட்டிவ். ஈவன் குளோரின் டசன்ட் ஃபார்ம் எனி ஹைட்ரஜன் பாண்டிங். ப்ரோமின் டஸ் நாட் ஃபார்ம் எனி ஹைட்ரஜன் பாண்டிங். பட் குளோரின் வில் ஃபார்ம் ஹைட்ரஜன். Oxygen will form hydrogen. Nitrogen will form hydrogen. We know that, we know that fluorine, then oxygen, then nitrogen. This is these are all the most highly electronic elements. Okay, idu mattum dhaan hydrogen bonding form pannu. Yes, hydrogen, yes, placed in between two highly electronegative. Enna nerudiraanga? Highly electronegative. Hen kedaiyadhu. Highly electronegative atoms. Appadina da adhu perena hydrogen bond. Say for example, let I'm assuming HF molecule. HF. Here also HF. We know that electronegativity of fluorine is more, electronegativity of hydrogen is less. Here also the same thing, H plus, F minus. Now the interaction will be taking place. Now we can understand this hydrogen will form hydrogen bonding, which is placed in between one to two highly electronegative atoms. Then only this one has hydrogen bonding. Is that clear? Prida, the hydrogen bond is in the place all know. ரெண்டு புளூரினுக்கு இடையில ரெண்டு ஆக்சிஜனுக்கு இடையில ரெண்டு நைட்ரஜனுக்கு இடையில ஆர் நைட்ரஜன் புளூரின் இடையில ஆர் நைட்ரஜன் ஆக்சிஜன் many combinations but hydrogen சென்டரா இருக்கும் right side left side யார் இருக்கும் either oxygen nitrogen fluorine இங்கயோ either nitrogen oxygen fluorine yeah Even HCl does not form hydrogen bonding because it has less electronegativity compared to fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen. Yeah, that is not very important. The hydrogen bonding. Please, Lia. Any doubt, Rikar? Any doubts? Other than that, no hydrogen bonding is formed. Does not form a hydrogen bonding because it has only weak van der Waals force of attraction. It's a non-polar molecule. Ethane is a non-polar molecule. Non-polar molecule na enna irukum van der Waals force of attraction na irukum boiling point. What do you mean by boiling point? Boiling point. Enna na? Water boil pandringa. Water boil liquid into vapor. Liquid to vapor, over temperature at the boiling point. Right? Then why different liquid have different boiling points? Density of atoms. Density of atoms. Force of attraction. Okay. Very nice. Boiling point is nothing but very simple. Water boil pandringa. Boil panna some bubbles will comes. Appadina enna artham? Water boil panna mudala ena oru vapors varum. Vapors beginning. Once the vapors will come, the vapor of the liquid which is equal to 1 atmospheric pressure. The vapor of the liquid should reach 1 atmospheric pressure. Then the liquid start to boil. Appa liquid to liquid area. Petrol adikiringa, kaiya vekiringa, chill irukke. Because it has less boiling point. Involving an endothermic reaction, it absorbs the heat and getting vaporized very easily. So the boiling point is less. That out there nothing. Okay, fine. But the gas part. Yes. Induced is nothing but one positive charge is there, one negative charge is there. That negative charge will induce the nearby molecule to make them positive or negative. That is dipole induced because it does not have any permanent dipole. Some molecule may have some permanent dipole. Some molecule may not have some permanent dipole. That molecules will have this kind of